This tutorial video will teach you some basic editing techniques on the timeline. On the timeline, to move a clip, simply click and hold the clip, then drag it to the desired position. If you want to split a segment, move the playhead to the position where you want to split, then click Split in the toolbar, or press the shortcut key Ctrl plus T. This will divide the clip into two segments. To undo the last edit, press Ctrl plus Z to undo, and press Ctrl plus Y to redo. You can also click the left and right arrows in the toolbar above to perform the same actions. If you want to delete unwanted clips, select the clip, then click the trash can icon in the timeline toolbar, or simply press the delete key on your keyboard to delete it. To copy a clip, right-click on it and select Copy, or press Ctrl plus C. Then, move to the desired location and select Paste, or press Ctrl plus V to insert the copied clip. If you want to adjust the length of a clip, move your mouse to the edge of the clip. When the cursor changes to this icon, click and drag to extend or shorten the clip. The menu that appears offers three different trimming methods. If you select Trim Only, the original position of the clip will leave an empty space and will not affect other clips. If you choose Trim and Move Clips, the clips on the same track will automatically move forward to fill the space. If you select Trim and Move All Clips, all subsequent clips on the timeline will move forward to fill the empty space. Select the one that best fits what you need when trimming clips. In the updated version of PowerDirector, a new auto ripple editing feature has been added. This feature allows you to trim or remove clips without having to manually select the editing option each time, improving the smoothness and efficiency of your editing. The auto ripple editing button is located at the top left of the timeline. If you don't see this button, go to Preferences, Editing, and check Enable Auto Ripple Editing for Remove Trim. If it still doesn't appear, please update PowerDirector to the latest version. When Auto Ripple Editing is enabled, the button will appear blue. Adjusting the length of a clip on the master track will automatically trim the clips on the tracks below, keeping them aligned with the master track. Clips located after the adjusted area will also automatically move forward to fill the gap. When deleting a clip, any clips on lower tracks that overlap the same time range will also be deleted. If this feature is disabled, the button will appear white. Adjusting or deleting a clip will only affect that clip itself, leaving gaps on the timeline, while other clips remain in their original positions. To revert to the original editing method, where the ripple editing menu pops up, simply go to Preferences and uncheck this option. When you add video clips to the timeline, the audio will appear on the corresponding audio track. You can unlink the video and audio to edit them independently. To unlink, right-click on the clip and select Link Unlink Video and Audio. This allows you to easily adjust the audio or delete unwanted parts. If you want to move or edit multiple media clips together, you can create a clip group. Select all the clips you want to edit, then right-click and choose Group Clips. This way, you can move all the media as a single unit. To ungroup the clips, right-click and select Ungroup Clips, and all the clips will be separated back into individual clips. When editing a video, you may need to adjust the playback speed to match the music or overall rhythm. Hold down Ctrl and move your mouse to the edge of the clip. When the cursor changes to a clock icon, dragging forward will speed up the clip, while dragging backward will slow it down. In video or image clips, move the mouse to the white line and drag up or down to quickly adjust the opacity. Doing the same on audio clips will adjust the volume.